Hello, welcome to channel 48. My name is Puck and in this video I'm going to show you how to upgrade your Samsung S5 Plus that is still running on the official firmware from Samsung. That could be Android 5 or Android 6. Before I'm going to tell you how to do it, I first want to invite you to subscribe to my channel, hit the notifying bell and leave this video a like, because at the end of this video you will be updated how to, you know, bring this phone into a 2018 state so you can use it safely, so you have the latest security patches installed and you will be able to receive updates on weekly, sometimes monthly basis, and you're gonna have a fantastic phone again. The Samsung S5 Plus, it comes with Knox, and Knox is in fact a partition that Samsung claims to be really secure. However, if you get into the phone, you might find that little number how to access that partition on the phone. So in fact, yeah, Knox is not so safe. Also, Knox has to do with the warranty of the phone. So whenever you're gonna install some custom ROM and it's gonna touch the Knox part, that it's gonna be deleted, then in fact you have no warranty on the phone anymore. You must know this. If you're gonna do this with the Samsung S9 or, you know, some S7 and the Knox will be removed, you know, then you have no warranty anymore if something happens with the phone. Probably if you're gonna crack the screen, it will be replaced. But if it's something with the software, you cannot go to Samsung and complain, my phone is not working. So that's for you. Okay, so you're gonna lose warranty. But this phone has no warranty anymore. This is an old phone. So what will we do? We're gonna upgrade it unofficially to official firmware. That sounds kind of double. Unofficially official. So what's up with that? Well, unofficially is because it will not be a Samsung update. Officially is because it's gonna get a firmware that is being officially developed on every day and that is also officially receiving updates. So in fact you're switching software on the phone. By switching the software on this phone, you're gonna get a better phone. Well, not every custom ROM is necessarily better for an Android phone, but the ROMs and the firmware that are created by Lineage OS, these are the best that you can ever get for the device. If the device is supported by Lineage OS, officially supported, it will work fine. That's why when people ask me what phone to buy, if they come to me, they say, Puck, you know a lot about phones, what phone shall I buy? Then I'm sending them to Lineage OS to look in that list of the phones that they support and choose a phone that they like from all that list. Most of the times it's gonna be some second-hand phone. So if you can find a brand new second-hand somewhere, you know, a phone that still looks great, just like this one, and that was not molested, has no scratches, does not stink, then probably you're gonna have a nice phone, one that will receive updates. So let me not make this video any longer. Let me tell you what we're gonna do so you can kind of understand the procedure. You will need a Windows computer. Most of you have Windows computers. You can also do this on a Mac or on a Linux machine, but I'm not gonna go there. I'm just gonna talk about the Windows PC. So if you have a Windows PC, you're gonna first install the USB drivers for Samsung devices. Just go on the internet and look for USB drivers for Samsung S5. And then it's gonna let you download the universal Samsung USB drivers. Download them, install them. So when you install the USB drivers, the phone will be recognized whenever we're gonna put it into a download mode. When it's in a download mode, we're gonna flash the custom recovery. What is the custom recovery? The custom recovery is in fact a state that we put the phone in if we want to change things from the phone, if we want to wipe the drive, and if we want to install official firmware, then you will have to put this phone into a download mode. But we also have the recovery mode. It's the difference with the recovery mode is that the stock recovery of this phone will be replaced by TWRP. And TWRP is in fact the recovery that we're going to use to then bring this phone to Android 7.12. We're not going to root it, so this phone will not be rooted. It's just going to get Lineage OS, and then the phone will be updated to 7.12. And then you can use this phone in every creative way you wish. We're also going to install the Pico Gaps on this thing, because this is not my phone, and I think that my friend Jan, he probably wants to use his Gmail and YouTube and so, you know, so we cannot expect from him to deal without these tools. So let's get started, guys. We already have the USB drivers installed. We already have Audin. We downloaded TWRP, and we even downloaded the custom firmware from Lineage OS. So we're gonna put this phone into a download mode. And how to do that? Well, it's really easy. Most of you know it already, but I'm making this video today for noobs. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna reboot the phone into a recovery mode, not into a download mode first, but we're gonna go into the recovery mode, and in the recovery mode we're gonna tell the phone to bring us to the bootloader. Now, to go into the recovery mode, make sure that your phone is turned off. Hold the volume, press volume up, the home and the power, and turn the phone on with these three buttons until you see that little blue light there. That will bring us into the recovery mode. Okay, and in the recovery mode we can scroll down with the volume buttons up and down, and we're gonna select to go to the bootloader, to reboot the phone into the bootloader. Okay, because from there out we're gonna then install TWRP, and then this recovery will be updated with the latest recovery for this phone that officially comes from TWRPme. So all credits to TWRPme for this fantastic recovery, this tool. And there we are in a recovery mode now. And next to do is, of course, to connect the cable. And we, at this point, already copied all the files that we need to the phone. That could be to the internal drive of the phone or to your SD card. We're gonna power up our Audin. There it is. We're going to select AP and go to the TWRP file that we installed. Make sure that the little green light is popping up, telling you that the phone is now flashed with the new recovery. And we're going to go back into the recovery mode. And now we will find out that the recovery is updated with TWRP. Yes, recovery. Okay, I think we did it. And we have TWRP installed. You see that? So what we now gonna do is we're just gonna swipe, and we're gonna do a wipe. So now we're gonna say goodbye to the Samsung software. I'm gonna in fact wipe everything. I'm cleaning this complete phone. Everything is being wiped. Okay, it said could not wipe the OTG, but that's not a problem. We're gonna go to install up a level, and one more up. Okay, there it is, Lineage OS, and let's go for it. Okay, it's done. We can now reboot the system. And now you just upgraded your Samsung S5 Plus unofficially to official Lineage OS 14.1. And there it goes.
Okie dokie. So we installed Android 7.12 Lineage OS 14.1 on the Samsung S5 Plus. This is a great update for the phone because the phone just became a better device. Just hit next and go to the pages and see if you can get into the home screen. But I'm sure you will. And there we are. Trebuchet is booting up. That's the launcher. And we are in our home screen. Android 7.12. Here you can see it at the bottom. See that? Android 7.12. The coolest of this all is that you also gonna receive updates. Updates are very important. Security updates are very important for your phone. Especially if you want to do important things with your phone. If you want to do banking and all these things, you know, you need it. So, up here, you can see that we're running Lineage OS 14.12. And we hit the refresh to see if there's any update. But there won't be any update because we took the latest version and downloaded that to the phone and installed it. Now, my friends, we will have to install GAPS. But GAPS will probably be blocked, and whenever we connect with our account to the Google Play Store, it will probably say that our phone is probably not supported, or we're not allowed to use the Play Store. So I'm not even sure how that works. It's the first time that I'm gonna test it out. Well, I already think of a workaround, and we're also gonna see if that workaround works for you. And if it worked, then we also learned how to bypass the Google block on the custom ROMs. Okay, so up here I'm just checking out the system a bit and putting the date right, because it's the 17th of May. But we're not connected to the internet yet, so I'm gonna connect to the internet real fast so we can kinda get this thing going and also get GAPS. I'm also gonna show you how to get at Onsu. So yeah, these are all the things that you still have to see in this video. Okay, and there we go, we are connected. So let's see if all the basic functions kinda work, such as camera. Hello? No. Okay, camera works. How to put it on video, like this. Is video working? Hello, 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 testing 1, 2, 3.
Hello, 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 testing 1, 2, 3.
Okay, so how about the selfie camera? How do we do that? Here, maybe, here, selfie. Hello, 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Hello, 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I like a wife. So this is very nice. You see, it works, it's updated, and your phone is now good to go. Enjoy your brand new second-hand Samsung S5 Plus. So that's how to update your Samsung S5 Plus to effect the latest Android version for this phone available, and that's 7.12, and I'm sure it's gonna get some Oreo update sooner or later. However, if you're gonna see that some guy is offering Oreo, you know, some developer, then you can of course go ahead and install Oreo. But hey, you're having official support now, you know? You're on Android 7.12, that is getting official supported. So it's getting all the security updates. So it makes no sense to go use some Android 8 that is not getting any updates and that was just created on the fly because, you know, somebody wanted to do a thing like that. This is official Lineage OS, and you will get updates on weekly, monthly base, nightlies, etc. These guys are working on the firmware of your phone. So always think twice before you're gonna just for a higher number build, you know, destroy something good to install something that is, you know, will not stay permanent on your device. So now we can also, of course, install PicoGaps. And let's go ahead and do that real fast. So we're gonna see if that also works.
Now there are many ways how you can get the PicoGaps. You can also go ahead and download them yourself with your phone. You type PicoGaps and then 7.1. That's what you type. And here you're gonna see the open Android open gaps project, and you're just gonna go and select this one here and then hit the download. Allow download. So now it's downloading to your download folder. Okay? About the root. If you want root, then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to Google and you're gonna type Lineage OS. I'm just showing you the simple way, okay? And then there you're gonna find lineageos.org. You're gonna select it, okay? And you're just gonna go to downloads. And you're gonna go all the way down, extra folder, where are the blood clot phones? Lineage OS, oh yeah, here, all the way down, you see extra. Okay, and you're gonna go for the 14.1. This one here, add on to ARM 14.1. You're gonna download it. You see? So here we have the downloads coming in. Download complete, download complete. They are both complete. AdOnSu is complete and the PicoGaps is also complete. Okay, so what we're now gonna do is we're gonna go into a recovery mode and we hit okay. We remove the cable, we start holding volume up and the home together. There it goes, you see that? And now it goes into recovery. There you go. So yeah, now we have it. We go one up, install, one level up, and then back to one level up. And we go to open gaps and we install open gaps. And then we will have to see if this all will still work or if we're gonna get some problem with connecting to the apps, to the Google apps, if we must first register or whitelist the device. But I don't think so, because this phone already came with gaps officially by Samsung, so I don't think that we should have to register this device. I think that's only for unofficial devices that were not having a deal with Google to install gaps. Because in fact, I never pushed gaps into my mods and my ROMs, because that what I'm doing is not officially Google. So I think Google also start thinking like that. So we just installed gaps, guys, and the phone is not rooted at this point. I did not install the add-on SU. I have it there, but probably I'm gonna make some beautiful mod for this thing. It's been a while that I created mods. We did lots of things with Linux and so. So yeah, I'm thinking of making a Linux. Yeah, I love Linux Mint so much. So I think I'm gonna make a Linux Mint ROM. And now we have GAPS installed, guys. We have the Google Play Store. You see that? There it is. And yeah, we should be able to connect to it. So I'm just gonna put one of my accounts in here. Checking info. Let me log in real fast. Okay, I just logged in, guys, and I'm not gonna back up to Google Drive. I agree. And the Google Play Store is working. So let's see if we can actually download something. Let's get YouTube. There is YouTube. Let's give it a 5-star rating there. No. I don't give it no rating. No. I'm not gonna hate my platform. I'm not like that. I'm not gonna do that. Your device isn't compatible with this version. Look at it. Look at what it's saying. Ay, mi gado. So can we download anything? Your device isn't compatible, so nothing is compatible. You see that? Your device isn't compatible, so we all get these kinds of things telling us it's not compatible. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, because now I'm kinda understanding what is happening. So meaning that our apps are not being we cannot install anything from the App Store, as you can see. So we're gonna do it differently. APK Pure is a very good site, and I'm gonna turn on unknown sources. So I think I found a little other way how to do this. Okay, this is really stupid. Now it's gone. Files, downloads, APK Pure, install. We're gonna take a Boropassi. Open. I think that the. I take no deny. I think that YouTube. Install. We're gonna take a Boropassi. A Boropassi means we're gonna enter via a different way. Okay? Because yeah, I'm getting a little bit treated like an idiot. As you can see, YouTube is working just fine. You see? So if we're gonna go for Gmail, APK Pure, no, deny, skip. So we can download each and every app. This is just, you don't have to register nada. You see that? By the way, I don't like this Gmail. I like this one more. it's better. It actually delivers status updates. As you see, it's working just fine. Your inbox works. Yeah, so we did install GAPS, but in fact we're not going to use GAPS. So what we're going to do, we're going to keep to the rules of Google. We're going to go to apps. And what we're going to do is we're going to go to the Google Play Store. And we're going to disable it. Disable the app. And force stop. Boom. We're never going to use it again. Only thing that we're going to use is the Google Play Surface. You see that? It's installed. We don't see anything here of Google. Only the Gmail, I think you see, and the YouTube. Where is the Gmail? It has a different icon. Let me see where it is. Oh, here it is. Inbox. This one here. You see that? And YouTube. So this is an easy workaround for you. So in fact you don't need to register anything. You can still use the Google apps, but you must find your own apps. It did install the twerp. Damn. I didn't want this thing, man. Go away. I mean, we already have the latest twerp, man. I got the twerp from the website. I don't want twerp on this machine. It's not needed. It's not needed. Disable app. And force stop, because it's also booting up. Very annoying. So, there you go. So, yeah. What can I say? You can install every Google app still, and you don't need to register or whitelist your phone, and in this way you will be able to easily get past these 100 times that you can actually install RAM. So yeah, this video did not only show how to upgrade your Samsung phone, but it also shows how you can by installing the Pico GAPS, still get each and every app, even though you cannot download anything from the Play Store. So yeah, I think a better information we could not give you today about upgrading and keeping your phone in shape.
Tja, in fact, no, I kind of feel stupid, you know, because yeah, it's almost like Microsoft in Windows 10 telling us, you know, you must first register before you can change the background, you know, of your desktop. I think they changed it around again, because I found it one of the biggest jokes, you know, because if you would go to a picture and right mouse click the picture, set as wallpaper, the wallpaper of your desktop would be changed. So, in fact, Microsoft telling you that you cannot change the wallpaper until you activate was, in fact, just, you know. And now I kind of feel a little bit the same about Google saying that it's not gonna, you know, because you don't have to download from the Play Store. As you can see, I just got APK Pure. And I can tell you that the files there at APK Pure, they are clean. You know, because if they were not, then APK Pure would hear it and probably they would get themselves in big trouble. You know, and nobody would ever download some app from them again. And I have good experience with APK Pure. So only thing you need to do to, you know, not being pushed in a corner that you cannot, your device is not supported, blah, 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 you know, is just install the Pico GAPS, make sure you have the Google Play Surface installed, you know, and then just go to some other APK store and get any APK from Google apps that you wish, and it's just gonna work fine.
So I feel a little bit stupid that it was so easy to fix. So Google, do something about it, huh? Because this is just a joke, of course. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you loved this video. I did not like it. I loved it. So if you loved it, leave this video a like. Don't leave without leaving this video a like, because you learned several things in this video. Again, see you in my next one.